let's dive into how to use Python virtual environments in Ubuntu. I'm using Ubuntu 24.04, but this should work on any Ubuntu version and most Linux distributions. Virtual environments are incredibly useful because they allow us to maintain different Python versions and dependencies for each project. This way, each project has its own isolated dependencies, making it easier to manage them without conflicts. Plus, switching between Python versions or sets of dependencies becomes straightforward. So in short, a virtual environment is essentially a folder that contains a specific version of Python, along with all the dependencies required for it. In this tutorial, we'll cover how to create a Python virtual environment, activate it, use it, and then deactivate it. Let's begin by ensuring that Python is installed on our system. Most Ubuntu versions come with Python pre-installed, but let's double check with this command. If I run it here, I can see that I have Python 3.12 installed. If you don't have Python, you can install it with these commands, though I won't be running them since Python is already installed on my system. Next, we need to install the venv module, which is what we'll use to create Python virtual environments. Let's run this command to install it. For me, it was already installed, but this will ensure it's available. Now let's make sure pip, the Python package manager, is also installed. Using pip will help us manage dependencies within our virtual environment, demonstrating how each project can have its own isolated packages. Here's the command to install pip. Again, I already have it, so it didn't install anything new. Now that we have both Python and pip ready, it's time to create our virtual environment. To create a virtual environment, we use this command, Python 3 dmvenv, followed by the name we want for the environment. In this example, I'm using .venv as the environment name, which is a common naming convention. It will take a moment to set up the environment, and now it's created. If we list our files, you might notice that our new virtual environment folder isn't visible. That's because any folder starting with a dot is hidden in Linux. Using a hidden folder for a virtual environment is typical to avoid cluttering the project directory. Even though it's hidden, we can navigate into it to confirm it exists. Inside, we see several files and folders, including a bin folder. In the bin folder, there's a file named activate that we'll use in a moment. Let's return to our main project folder. Now, let's activate our virtual environment. To do this, we'll run the activate script using the source command. As soon as we run this, notice that our command prompt changes to show the virtual environment name at the beginning, indicating it's active. While this environment is active, any Python packages we install will be contained within this environment and won't affect the global Python installation. Now, let's test this by installing an example package. We'll use pip to install the requests package, which is used for making HTTP requests. I'll go ahead and install it now. The package is installed, but it's only available within this virtual environment and doesn't affect any other projects or the global Python scope. Let's try running a small Python program that uses requests. I'll create a new Python file for this, using nano, but feel free to use any text editor you prefer. This example program will send a request to the GitHub API and print the HTTP status code of the response. Let's run it to see if everything's working. And as expected, the program ran without issues because the requests dependency was installed in our virtual environment.